If you could have smelled it, your family's in charge. We only need to try to close out, pick up four more wickets to close out Friends United. Friends United batsmen have struggled to cope with the pace of the wicket. And when they've looked to accelerate, tumbling wickets have stemmed their slow growth. And so far it's been a good performance by New York Friends. And so single well closed out over number 11. Four runs coming from it. A successful over from the Budapest Multi. And so it's 76 with 11 overs completed.
Thank you.
Gritty has come back quite well. He's taken to the cleaners by Andrew McCarthy in his first over, but he has fought back with the three brilliant overs. And really stepped up to the plate here. And he'll come back for a couple. And so, 76-6. One ball remaining in order. Number 13. So that closes out the over. Just four runs from it. Multi wrapped up. So it was 2 for 27. And so excellent bowling by Multi bowling straight through. With 76-6. With 13 overs gone. So 42 balls remaining in the innings here. And Friends United in Spotify. Davis takes him up to 4. 77 then the total. Nabeed comes back onto strike. Working this one into the outside once again. Sean Finley comes off the mid-wicket fence. Deron Davis back on strike. 8 to Nabeed, 4 to Davis. Haven't seen any meaningful partnership at this point from Friends United. Again, contemplating a single, not there. No response from Deron Davis. This one is well driven up into the offside. Kenyon Lewis on his horse. He comes up through it. And the batters are coming back to a second. And in the end, they do get there safely. So that takes the total up to 80 for the loss of 6 wickets.
Yeah, a couple of leg spinners here, Chantapal Hemraj and Rulakesh Malti. They've done well, and we've seen quite a few others of spin bowling. And of course, we would have seen Drysdale quite briefly when we saw the jump shot. And we also saw Marvin Stewart that performed the bowling attack. For the New York Diamonds, no pressure on them at all. The over is completed. 14 overs down. 8 for 6 at the end of 14. With Labib on 8, Deron Davis on 6. 36 balls remain. 8 for 6.
Josh Shah has been reintroduced. Three overs, 1 for 16 in his first spell. Picked up the all-important wicket of Stephen Taylor. And second up, he was the second dismissal with the score of 13. And Taylor, 80 for 60 total on the board. And then strikers, Ahmed Nabeed. And over to the other side. They run for one. And that's all they'll get. So, the lead goes up to Lee. Takes it total up to 8-1. 45 balls remaining in the innings for Friends United. Going at less than run a ball at this juncture with 35 deliveries to go. 5.7 runs per over puts them on course for a total sub 120. If they should continue at that same rate. See the wide ball go down the leg side. So a bit of confirmation from umpire Khan.
So Nadav Shah.
And who will that have?
The new cricket for Pakistan. He has a very extensive first-class career. He did play for Pakistan International Airways, along with Pindi. With Derbyshire and the English Cricket League, so been around the globe. He's a top competitor. Seen him many times at the US Open, having been part of the Somerset Cavaliers unit. Nadav Shah is their captain, and he's led well. He's won the US Open 2 times in 3 years, so that alone. It's a testament to the fact that Nadav Shah has really left well. He's played well himself. Comes into the final of the Columbus Day T20 as really a top performer.
And this one, some 134 first-class matches under his belt. Some of the main listening matches he's also played at the ODI level. And 18 T20 matches. So an experienced campaigner is Nadav Shah. And again, that just again just speaks to the quality of the talent on display here.
Get up!
So
he's such a tall bowler that even if, as they say, he can wake up a dead pitch because he gets a lot of bounce, especially when he throws to the right-hander. Trying to slam the ball across the right hander, so he's really a hamper. And he bowls with some bit of pace still at this level. So 83 for 6, 32 balls remaining. Labib is on 9.
Looking for a good day with the bat here. Last time we would have seen him, would have been on the verge of scoring 200s in one day. Just missing by just a solitary run. And in the end, the inside to injury, he couldn't have happened as Kenar Lewis. He might have pulled a hammy there in the process. The ball crosses the boundary. 4 runs to Labib, takes him up to 13. More importantly, Kenar Lewis is down for the count. Whoever concludes, 7 runs from it, it's 87 for 6. 87 for 6 with 15 overs game.
So 87 for 6. 50 is gone. 87 for 6. So former ball hemorrhage continues still. It's only 9 for 6. The ball worked into the outside and looking for 2 to 7 for 1. So similar to Deron Davis, which is going to 88 for 6. 88 for 6. We are in over number 16 being bowled here by Chandra Paul Hemraj. Stanley LeBeck, he's on 13. Deron Davis on 8. We've seen a partnership of 20 so far. Can score again, so a good feeling there from Sean Finley. Making sure that the batsman stay for a dot ball, 88 for 6. He's given up seven runs. The side of Bella takes over from the middle position. Kimmer Lewis is momentarily off. So 8 to 9 to 6, 25 balls remaining. We're in over number 16. And so far, Hemraj is bowling it very, very tight and tidy. This is a typical wicket, and so another over comes to an end. And at the end of 16, it's 9 to 6. 9 to 6 at the end of 16. So Twinsdale comes back into the attack, 211 for 12. We've got 24 balls remaining. Deron Davis, the man on strike.
Punched up into the outside for a couple. Into his third over. He's bowled 1 for 17 so far. 3 runs off the first over. 9 off the second over. And 4 off the first over, including a run. 9 off the second over. And he's conceded 3 here so far. Into 2 balls already. Here's Drysdale. And this one is pulled through, straight through. Oh, short and long. And good back up to prevent the ball running away from runs. Had to sacrifice the body. And in the end, comes up with a lot of pain.
So 94 to 6.
Keep going, Ahmed Labib will be the man on strike. He'll get the free swing. It's a long drive there.
Is the man on strike? Drysdale is struck it well, straight up to Saeed Abdullah. And only a single, so we've seen what they're calling. We've seen 2 three-hit ball. But relative to that, the New York Diamonds have really bowled well. And even the three-hit ball hasn't really gone for plenty.
Yes, so 97 for 6. Diamonds are really putting a stellar bowling performance. All the bowlers have bowled very, very well. Economical, wicket taking. This one is hit well. Off hand over, short pitch delivery, and it's hammered. And by Deron Davis, and it's back from that team. 100 for 100. Grand United, 100 comes up in over number 17.
Passing up a shot from Deron Davis, short, and he gives it a good block. And that's a great looking shot from Deron Davis. He goes up to 19 off 19. It's 103, so they crossed the 100 mark. Big psychological difference.
Big hit.
Come down the track again. Abdullah can't pull it in. It's like a set of the boundaries off the building of Drysdale. And that's a very good shot. A couple of good shots from Deron Davis. He goes up to 23 to 107.
And Friends United lead it at Overland. 17 runs from it. And so one of the taller buildings in that Manhattan skyline. And it all comes courtesy of Deron Davis. 23 from 20. So this partnership of 39 between Davis and Labib. The best partnership we've seen in the day from the Friends United squad. Partnership of 38 between McCarthy and Junaid Nadir for the next closest. And after that, there have been no partnerships that have passed 7. And so 2 good partnerships here for Friends United as they try to recover here to some semblance of respectability. 107 for 6 with 18 balls in there. Can the ball him match to continue? 3 overs, 9 for 9 so far, so he hasn't picked up a wicket, but has been very economical. So he'll continue the attack and he'll bowl to Ahmed Labib. Labib on 16, he's faced 24 balls so far, so striking it at just 67. And so with 18 balls, he's going to pick up that strike rate. Here is Himraj. Swing and a miss at a ball outside the off stump. So the good bowling of Hemraj continues, bowling at the depth.
So they bowl just about 6 runs and over for one thing straight down the ground.
Oh, well done by do it, sacrificing the body. And that goes cross for a couple. So that looked like it was going certainly for a boundary. Do it.
Yeah, good commitment there. Save the boundary, save a couple of runs. It's 109-6. This one could beat the gap. And there comes around. Can't get there in time and it goes a little forward. So, some productive shots, some runs towards the end here now off the back of Labib. This time from Deron Davis a couple of balls ago. It's 113-6.
So good intent on the part of Labib and Davis. Their partnership now then up to 45. And so flourishing partnership here. They'll have to try to stick together to stay to the very end.
That's 129, the projected score, Hamrad. Labib works it into the outside. Abdullah comes around. He's had a lot of work to do. He does well at staying the boundary. They come back for a couple of runs. And as we have seen, Carl, in the earlier part, when Kinar Lewis was in patrolling that area. That area is a very high trafficking area. It's 115-6.
Yes, man. And still a couple of balls remaining in over number 18.
So 14 balls remaining, they'll work into the offside. Labib picks up another run, so the partnership now has gone up to 48. Labib goes up to 25, Deron Davis is on 23. And it's 116 on the board, 13 balls remaining. Safe as houses. And so another wicket goes down. Deron Davis fall to 23 to 116-7.